Hello everyone, in today's video we'll see how to create this really cool halftone splash effect that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. Now as you can see, this is some of the example I created using the same effect. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Alright, now before we're gonna start our tutorial, make sure to download this pattern that we'll be using for this tutorial and this scan textures by Ninja Rabbit down from the description below. You'll find a link to each of these assets that we'll be using for this tutorial. Alright, so open Adobe Photoshop and I will go to File, New, and we're gonna create a new document with 1920 for the width and 1080 for the height, and in the resolution I will keep it 300 and RGB in the color mode, and I will press OK. Alright, now the first thing that we're gonna do is to create the background. Now I will go to this foreground color in here and I will one click to it, and I'm gonna change the black to 15% and I will press OK. Now I will fill the background with this color that we just created, so I'm gonna press Alt Backspace and this will fill it with my foreground color in here. Now I'm gonna unlock this background in here by one click to this lock in here, and I will call it BG for background. Alright, now I'm gonna double click to it and this will open the light side dialog, and I will go to gradient overlay. And probably when you will open the gradient overlay, you won't find it the same as I do in here. So just make the style radial and opacity 50%, and in the gradient in here, just open it. You will probably find it black to white in here. So just make the black white. So one click to this black in here and change it to white. And in this color stop in here, make sure the opacity stop set to 0 and click OK. Now in the angle in here, put 30 and the opacity make it 50% and press OK. Now because we apply a gradient overlay to this background in here, you can clearly see the color shades that created from the background. So we need to get rid of that. So we can easily do that by applying a little bit of noise to this background in here. So I will go to filter and I'm gonna choose noise and I will add noise. Now I will put 3% in the amount and I will make it uniform and monochromatic is checked, and I will press OK. Alright, now as you can see, this got rid of the color shade that we just had before. Alright, so I will go and open the picture I will be using. So I will choose this one in here and open it in a new window. And I'm just gonna take it and drag it and open it in here. And I will close this for now. Alright, so I'm gonna convert it to a smart object. So I will right click and choose convert to smart object. And I'm gonna press Ctrl T and I will make it smaller as right here. And I'm gonna try to center it. That's right there. And I'll press Enter. Now I'm gonna make a copy of it. So I'm gonna press Ctrl J and I will call this Halftone. And I will call this other one Normal. And I will hide the normal picture for now. And I'm gonna apply two filters for this halftone in here. But before I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna make sure my foreground and background color is set to default. So just press D on your keyboard and it will set the color to default. Now we'll go to filter and I'm gonna choose filter gallery. And the first filter that we'll be using is in the artistic folder in here. So just open it and choose poster edge. Now for these filters in here, it depends on the resolution of your image. You might not have the same values, or you might not use the same values I would be using for this picture. So just make sure to adjust the values and, you know, experience with it before you apply it on your picture. So for this image in here, I'm gonna put 10 in the edge thickness, and in the edge intensity I will keep it 1, and in the posterization I will keep it 2, and I will press OK. Now I will go to this blending option of this filter gallery right here, and I will double click to it, and as you can see this will open the blending option for this filter in here, and I'm gonna change the opacity 70%, and I will press OK. Alright, now I will go back to filter again, and I'm gonna choose filter gallery, and the second filter is in the sketch folder in here, so I will open it, and I'm gonna choose halftone pattern. Now again, it depends on the resolution of your picture, you might need to experience with the values of this filter in here. So for this picture I'm gonna put the size 2, and the contrast I will put 35, and I will press OK. And again I will go to the blending options and double click to it, and I'm gonna set the opacity 70%, and I will press OK. Alright, now I want to apply a black layer mask to this image in here. So I'm gonna press Alt and make sure your image is selected, and press Alt and one click to this layer mask icon in here. And as you can see this will make it black, and as you can see the picture is disappeared. Now if you don't find it black and you find it white, you can always just select the layer mask and go to the properties in here and open it and choose inverse, and this will invert it to white if I had it black, and for this one in here now I have it white, if I click invert it will invert it to a black. Alright, now I will go and open the scan textures in here. I'm gonna choose one of these textures in here, you can choose whatever you want. So I would go with this one in here and open it in a new window, and I'm just gonna take it and drag it to the other window in here and put it in here, and I will just close this for now. Now I'm gonna press Ctrl T and I will make it smaller to fit my window in here, and I'm gonna press Enter. Now I want to make this texture to black and white because it has a little bit of blue in it, so I'm gonna press Ctrl Shift U and it will convert it to black and white. And also I want to darken it more because I'm gonna use it for the layer mask in here, so I'm gonna press Ctrl L and this will bring the level adjustment in here. I'm gonna take the matte tones and put it into the right, that's a little bit. And I will bring back a little bit of the white for the texture. That's right there. And I will press OK. Now I want to select these textures and copy it. Now I will select my texture in here, and by pressing Ctrl and one click to this texture, it will load the selection for this texture in here. So I'm gonna press Ctrl C, or you know, you can go to Edit and choose Copy. And I will deselect it by pressing Ctrl D, and I'm gonna hide it for now. Now keep in mind that I already copy my my texture. Now I will go and select this halftone image in here, and I'm gonna unlink the link in between the layer mask and the picture. So I'm gonna one click to this link icon in here and it will disappear. So this means that they're not linked anymore. So I will select the layer mask, and by pressing Alt and one click to it, it will allow me to enter the layer mask in here. So I'm gonna press Ctrl V, and what this does, it will paste the texture that I copied from the texture in here. Now I have it inside the layer mask, and that's what we want. So I'm gonna press Ctrl D to deselect. Now if I exit the layer mask by clicking just on outside of it in here, as you can see we have the texture inside the layer mask, and I can take it and put it wherever I want. So it will allow me to create this really neat effect in here. And I can also press Ctrl T and make this texture big or small because I have it unlinked from the image in here. So I'm gonna make it bigger a little bit, and I will rotate it just right here, and I will make it bigger, right there. Alright, I think this looks good, and I will press Enter. Alright, now I'm gonna make a copy of this halftone, so I'm gonna press Ctrl J, and I will go and inside the layer mask, and I will make it a little bit smaller. So I'm gonna press Ctrl T again, and I will make it smaller, just like that. And I'm gonna place it just right here, so you can see the effect. Just like that. All right, I think we'll do for now. But I'm gonna change the blending option of the halftone filter in here. So I'm gonna double click to the blending option in here, and I'm gonna change the blending mode to soft light, and I will press OK. And now I'm gonna change the blending mode of this whole picture in here by going to this blending mode in here, and I'm gonna change it to linear burn. And as you can see, this will create this really cool effect in here. So I'm gonna go back to the layer mask in here, and I'm gonna press Ctrl T, and I'm gonna adjust it more, and I'm gonna press enter. Now as you can see, we have this really cool effect in here. Now I will go and grab the normal picture in here and put it just right here, and I will delete this one for now, and I will make it visible, and I'm gonna apply a black layer mask again to it. So I'm gonna press Alt and one click to the layer mask in here, and I will go back this time and grab a new texture. You can choose whatever texture you want. I'm gonna go with this one in here and open it again in a new window, and I will take it and drag it just like that. And again, I'm gonna press Ctrl T, and I will make it smaller, and I will press enter. And again, I'm gonna convert it to a black and white. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Shift U, and I will darken it a little bit. So I'm gonna press Ctrl L, and this will bring the level adjustment, and I will darken it from the mid tones in here, just like that. Bring a little bit of the whites, just like so, and I will press OK. Now I need to copy it again, so I'm gonna press Ctrl and one click to this texture in here, and it will load the selection again. And I'm gonna press Ctrl C to copy, and Ctrl D to deselect, and I will hide it for now. And again, I will go and I will unlink the linking between the layer mask and the image by one click to it, and it will unlink it. And I will Alt and one click to the layer mask, and as you can see, this will allow me to enter the layer mask in here. Now I'm gonna press Ctrl V so I can paste my texture in here, and I'm gonna press Ctrl D to deselect, and I will exit the layer mask by one click to this picture. And I'm gonna select the layer mask and press Ctrl T, and I'm gonna make my texture a little bit smaller because I want it to be just right here. That's right there. Alright, and I will press enter. Alright, and of course you can add as many texture as you want by doing the same steps again. And I think this looks good for an example. So I'm just gonna delete this texture in here, and I will apply the halftone pattern that we just download in here. So I will go and choose patterns in here, and in this arrow in here, I will one click to it, and this will open the pattern that I have in here. Now to load the pattern that you download, you just go to this gear icon in here and click load, and you know, load the pattern from your hard drive, and you will find three halftone pattern in here. So I will select the first pattern in here, and I will make the scale 50%, and I will press OK. Now I don't want it to be covered the whole image in here, so I will go and select the layer mask, and I will invert it to black. So I'm just gonna select it and go and open the properties, and I'm gonna choose invert, and as you can see, this will invert it to black. Now I will go to the gradient tool and make sure your foreground color is white, and the gradient style is radial, and I will go to the middle, and I'm just gonna one click and hold just like this, and then I will let go. And as you can see, this will add the halftone pattern in here. I'm gonna add a little bit more in here. All right, I think it looks good. and I will go to the layer mask again and I will select it, and again I will open the properties and I'm gonna make the density around 90%, because I want it to be visible a little bit in the background in here, but not that much. Alright, I think it starts to look good. Now I'm gonna apply a curve adjustment to it, so I will go and choose curves and I'm gonna make one point in here and I'm gonna take it and drag it down a little bit. It's like that's right there, just right here, and I'm gonna make another point in here and I'm gonna drag it up. Just like that. And I will go again to adjustment, and this time I'm gonna choose exposure. Now I'm gonna take the offset in here and put it into the right a little bit, around 0.0125, and I'm gonna take the gamma correction and again I'm gonna put it into the right around 0.90, as like so. Let me just reduce the opacity of this halftone pattern to 70%. And the last adjustment that we'll add is a vibrance, so I will go and choose vibrance in here, and I'm gonna make the vibrance 50 and the saturation 25. And as you can see, this will add a little bit of color to this part in here, and that's what we want. See, it looks really good. And there you go. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment on your new ways for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.